Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be presenting my systematic review on knowledge, awareness, and practice of forensic odontology among dentists in India. So next slide, please. So forensic odontology is basically the branch of dentistry that addresses the proper handling and examination of dental evidence and the evaluation and presentation of dental findings in the interest of justice.
So this relatively small specialty
within forensic science has been utilized for many years, especially in the area of establishing identity in natural and man-made disasters. Like the first forensic dental identification in India that was reported in a review by Sensor and Dayal in 1995, according to which Raja Jayachandra, third of Kannauj, died on battlefield in 1191, and the body was identified by his false anterior teeth. And this was probably the first case of identification using dentition from India. So a general dentist, apart from having a broad background knowledge of general dentistry, should also possess basic knowledge of the role of forensic pathologist, methods used in autopsy, and the role of dentist in the identification of a person, and the importance of maintaining dental records of all the patients. But unfortunately, in India, qualified forensic odontologists are very few. And this is probably due to the lack of proper awareness. Neither the government nor the people have completely understood the role. So the present systematic review was conducted to report on knowledge, awareness, and practice of forensic odontology among dentists in India. So materials and methodology. The present systematic review included observational cross-sectional studies conducted in India in PubMed database, and the subjects limited to dental professionals only, including dental practitioners, oral pathologists, and academicians in India. The studies evaluated the knowledge, awareness, and practice of forensic odontology as outcome measures, and the studies that were included were from 2011 to 2020 and from urban areas only. The articles that were excluded were narrative reviews, critical reviews, commentaries, opinions, and editorials. So next slide, please. So the present review of literature was carried out both electrically and manually, and the literature search was carried out through searches on Medline, PubMed database, and manual search. The total of 190 papers were identified with this method, and only 6 were retained with full text. And the review was done according to the guidelines set by the PRISMA. And the pre-specified data was extracted from each of the studies, including study design, sample size, practice regarding forensic odontology among dentists. The next slide. So next slide, please.
We are on the next slide. There is a table with a 6 rows. Dr. Venu, can you see the slide? Dr. Venu, we are not able to hear you. Jury member Dr. Amreen or Parul ma'am, slide is visible to you all?
Yes, I can
see the slide. It is the table with the references.
Yeah, so Venu Dahiya, I think, can you unmute?
Yeah, sorry for the connection problem, sir. Sorry.
Okay, please go.
So the 6 studies were included. The first one was Preethi et al. In 2011 in Tamil Nadu about the knowledge, attitude, and practice of forensic odontology. And the results showed that there was inadequate knowledge, poor attitude, and lack of practice of forensic odontology. Then a study by Shetty and Ravi Prakash in the same year in Karnataka about confidence in handling and practical exposure to forensic cases, knowledge, and awareness in forensic odontology. And the results showed that there was lack of confidence among subjects about handling forensic cases. Then a study by Khair et al. In Madhya Pradesh about awareness and knowledge of forensic odontology showed that there was low knowledge among subjects about the application of forensic odontology. Then a study in 2014 by Sen Gupta et al. In Uttar Pradesh about maintenance of detailed dental records for victim identification showed that most of the subjects were familiar with the subject, but only few of them were maintaining the dental records. Then a study by Rahman et al. In 2017 in Bhubaneswar about the same showed that there was adequate knowledge and awareness about the forensic odontology, but the subjects failed in practice for maintaining dental records. And a study by Renuka et al. In 2019 in Bhivavaram about the knowledge, awareness, and practice of forensic odontology showed that there was lack of proper training and confidence in handling forensic-related cases. So the data extracted from the study showed that according to the study of Preethi et al., only 12% dentists were maintaining the complete dental records. According to the same study, 40% of the dental practitioners did not have expertise to identify child abuse. According to the study of Shetty and Pravi Prakash, almost all the subjects were familiar with the subject, but only 7% were exposed to formal training in forensic odontology. And according to Kerr et al., 96% of subjects have knowledge regarding forensic odontology, but only 4% have contributed towards solving cases related to forensic odontology. So next slide, please. So next slide. According to Sen Gupta et al., only 3% of subjects have contributed to identification of victims in mass disasters. And according to Rehman, 90% of subjects had adequate knowledge, but only 40% of them were aware about the required time period for maintaining dental reports. And according to Renuka, 7.2% of subjects were trained and confident in handling forensic-related cases. So the data showed the level of knowledge, awareness, and practice of forensic odontology in present scenario. So the study also had some limitations, like it was based on the earlier studies that were conducted in different time periods by different authors. So the generalization may be inaccurate. Also, one study compared the knowledge levels of practitioners and academicians, while the other engaged the dental practitioners and oral pathologists. So this type of sampling could account towards the different level of knowledge and awareness. Also, the study was done only in urban areas. So coming to the conclusion, the result of the present review showed that the knowledge and awareness level of the subject is increasing with time, but not being adequate enough with the low attitude and practice scores. Also, to maximize the dental application in forensic cases, it is necessary that the dental practitioners should know the basic principles and techniques of the subjects. And also the forensic odontology courses can be introduced as a separate course by the dental council to specialize in the subject. And also forensic dental investigation mainly depends on the availability of antemortem reports. Therefore, it is very necessary to maintain a proper antemortem reports. So to conclude my presentation, I must say the importance of providing proper education and training in forensic odontology is currently the need of the hour. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Behia.
These are my references.